Welcome to my travels. My name's Neil. Cape Town, South Africa. Nice ride into the city. Excited, we are off sightseeing. Botanical Gardens is central in the city and it's a joy to explore. Many interesting buildings adjoin the park. A nice cafe in the park and a cool drink. A lovely thing in Cape Town, one is always overlooked by Tabletop Mountain. The next day, we joined the on-off bus to explore. First stop, Tabletop Mountain. Haha, disaster, rain. So we stayed on the bus to the waterfront. The sea lions were very busy. The waterfront is beautiful with lots of shops and restaurants. Four South Africans who have received the award. Love the rhinos. Time to explore and have some lunch. We rejoined the on-off bus. Kirstenbosch National Botanical Garden. They say there are 18 peaks, but it depends the way you count. Around a 3-hour drive through beautiful countryside. A quick stop along the way. For me, a city boy, I was very excited. The next few hours were just wonderful. The pictures will speak for themselves. Thank you. Hot and dusty, they provided a very nice refreshment stop. A wonderful day as we head back to Cape Town. Tabletop stands out as we get close to the city. An early start as we deposit our bags for the ship, then head over to the waterfront. Yoga time. We sail to Walvis Bay, Namibia. Time to relax with a show and dinner. Met by JD, we set off on a wonderful adventure. Quiet, yet close to town. Sand dunes on our left as we head to the desert. The highest dune over 1,256 feet. Being sand, the dunes are always moving. You can see the top of a palm tree sticking out of the sand. The desert has an aura of beauty and mystery, all of its own. Interestingly, when one looks across the surface of the desert, one can see a green tint of the lichen. To obtain moisture. It has, however, a salty flavour. A nice surprise. this is just the most amazing sight. Going back millions of years, and I understand slowly sinking into the desert. We are the little dots on the horizon. One can see the shape of its stem just above the sand. It also only ever has two leaves. You can clearly see the lichen growing on this rock. Great thing, JD parks by the road and protects the desert. This was amazing, a desert oasis to ourselves, just one vehicle. JD took us along the riverbed, rough in places as it gets very few vehicles. Some trees and plants survive the dry condition. The rock formations are spectacular. Thank you. bird's nest. On the lookout for animals, we were rewarded. As we sail, I look back on a day I will never forget. From our balcony, Robben Island, and the whales kept us amused. Very busy, we explored on Earth. We took a taxi to the waterfront. A good spot to start. The waterfront's got many piers with great views. Sandy beaches. It was really enjoyable. Showtime. The ship kept us well entertained in the evening. First off, we had an adventurous day planned. took the boat to the nearby island of Inhaka. Ashore, we headed to the local village. Early, we beat the local stallholders. It was nice to explore the interior of the island with its many walkways. Amazing, no matter how dry, one will always find plants and flowers. The mangroves were alive with small crabs. Rust and a few rails missing. After exploring the beach, we found a lovely place to relax. The local ferries. Not sure I would travel on one. Sad, a nice looking hotel that has closed. A lovely lunch. Thank you. Back on Portuguese Island, we found a beautiful spot under the trees. In Haka Island, heading back to the ship, the towels make good sun protection. Ready for a new adventure. Miles of beautiful beach. It takes about 2 hours to walk around the island, with few people along the way. Thank you. A perfect spot. Two wonderful days. Relaxing and fun day aboard. Leaving the ship, we had a tour outside of Durban. Very lush and green. Boy meets girl and proposes. Can you pay my dowry of 8 cows? He can. The big event takes place. Thank you. most enjoyable. We then had the opportunity to see inside a traditional Zulu home. I hope you enjoyed our travels. Neil.